two, and Weaselgon. So in this episode, welcome to Weaselgon. So in this episode, we're gonna talk about, we're gonna just play Weaselgon. I'm gonna show you all of the modes and everything what is possible. Anyway, let's get started. So first things first, we go to single player. I don't have a friend, so I can't go to multiplayer, but we can always try. You can only try online challenges, but that's it. We will start off with arcade. So there are three difficulties. The fourth is the master, but I haven't unlocked that yet. And we can pick a ship. Have I completed even rookie? Yeah, I have. And let's go for the easiest level for now. I mean, I played this game before, but you guys haven't seen anything. So what you do in this game is you pick up humans. Now this game used to be free, but it's not. I guess it makes sense because this game was so good. See these green enemies over here? This is a like green shiny enemy. Yeah, you have to kill all of them. And then there's like this green light.
Shields.
You have boost. You can shoot only left and right. There are power-ups coming out.
Weapon power up.
And these humans give you different power-ups. Nearly every mode is about getting humans. Nearly every, except for one. Or two. Yeah, there's a multiplier over there. And you get more points, obviously. I'll tell you guys what is an overdrive once I get it. You see these green cubes left after enemies, like these. These are as well as their points. Oh! There are green enemies here, but they will go out after a while.
Complete.
The green things are as well as your points, but also they are for your overdrive. The green bar below. In the top left corner, you are able to see your like... I think I made a gameplay of this before, but I'm not sure. In the top left corner, you are able to see your... your how much of bombs you have, and how much of lives. Everything you need to know is on the screen. The cool thing is that you don't need to get an enemy to keep your multiplier. You just have to hit an enemy, not kill. Your multiplayer does wear off after a while, but no, nothing to worry. Also, there's special humans, which we unlock after a certain multiplier is reached.
Weapon power up.
So if I would get like instead of multiplier by 3, I would get multiplier by 2. I wouldn't get the human in time. Okay, so this is the overdrive. You're basically invincible. And this was my overdrive. I used up the green bar below. Okay, so the point is just to basically shoot and save people.
Bomb.
Okay, so you just got an extra bomb. Where's the three? You guys see where the three is? These are my bombs. Because I just got an extra bomb, I have 3 bombs instead of 2.
Maximum multiplier.
This game does require a lot of concentration, but not as much as you guys think. It actually does. And the faster you kill the enemies, the more points you get. So it's really good to use boost a lot. See the green bar below? Yeah, it's charged because of the green dots that are left of the enemy. See this? Yeah.
All humans saved.
Awesome! All humans saved, that's awesome. Now there's not going to be a boss, so I'm not gonna use my overdrive. And because it's arcade mode, whatever I got in this level, we're going to the next level. So including the multiplier and everything, whatever I got here, it's going to go to the next level. So because I have 3 bombs and 3 lives, they will go to the next level. Because it's the arcade. But if I would go to a single level, once this level is over, it's over. I will not go to another level. So arcade mode is kind of easier. Anyway. I'm just not gonna speak because there's nothing really to talk here too much. Except for the blue bar below. That shows how close you are to a boss. There are 3 stages. So out of all killed enemies, this boss is alive. I'm gonna pass 2 levels, and I will go straight onto the final level, and then I will go to a higher difficulty. Okay, so we destroyed its outside, like its shelter. Ah, too late. You can make the explosion by having overdrive. By just letting go at the right time. Armageddon. I mean, look at it. It has pixels, but in a really cool, decorative way. So we got 9 million points in our first score. That's nice. In order to survive, you need to make use of all the mechanics in the game. That's right. There's the boost, there are bombs, there's the overdrive. And see our multipliers here. Now in all the difficulties, the enemies spawn faster. There's no more enemies, but they just spawn faster. But on master difficulty, there's like a secret difficulty after master called the hero. And to get the hero, you need to pass all of the levels in arcade.
Shield.
Not one by one, all. But because I'm usually left over in mastery mode, like with 1 or 2 lives, I can't. Like with 1 life, I can't to the next level. I need to have at least 2 lives. Because they know I will die.
Shields expire.
Okay, let's try to get all of the humans here too. And let's try to not die. And you know what? I will actually show the all of, he gets all of the levels. At least you guys will see all of the
phase complete.
All of the enemies one by one. And how good I am at this game. I don't think I am that good at this game though. I think I'm like decent but not that good. Oh god. Because if it wouldn't be good, I would stop using the same spaceship over and over again. Because I think this is like the best spaceship, that's my opinion. Because it can shoot also behind you without you yourself shooting behind you. Anyway. Oh, we're keeping the multiplier pretty nice. Yeah, after a while the enemies do get red. And they're like really, really bad version of the normal enemies. You don't want them to be angry, don't you? Okay, let's just keep up the good multiplier so we can get the special human also. He should be coming out any second by now. Every time she says keepers detected, it means that there's like they're green enemies. Cause they are called keepers. The green enemies are called keepers. There are two modes. When I said there is one mode that doesn't require you saving humans, but I was wrong, there's two modes. I just reminded. Okay, so these guys, you need to kill them in order. In order to get a human. I'm sure they could kill me here. So yeah, four bombs and we have an extra life.
Phase complete.
Yay, we got the special human. Which we will give us probably only parts. Now, there are these parts here.
Points.
And there are always two pods, except in hero mode and in mastery mode. There's only one. Also in mastery, there are fireballs after enemies. When you kill an enemy, you have to dodge the fireballs. But it's so easy to get points in mass in the hero mode. And here I would like to use the bomb, but I'm not gonna do that. I don't think it's a long time, but at least I'll get more points. I think so. When the multiplayer is full, that means it will not go down or up. Blue, not full, blue. I don't think I will die here for some reason, but just don't say that. This is rookie mode. This is rookie, so this is easy. But we will go into harder mode in a second.
Shields expired.
And you will guys see the difference between rookie and experiment, for example. Okay. Still no death, which I think it's pretty good to have completed the Okay, so you guys missed the explosion, but that's fine. 25 million points. Be on the lookout for Keeper's Kingdom and the correct order within. Yeah.
Save the last humans.
There's supposed to be a human coming down soon enough. Well, not really a human, but Keepers coming soon. Oh, yeah, there they are. Oh, shit! Didn't see that coming. Well, that's unfortunate, but you know, we can't get everything all the time. I think we will hit up here 5 lives. If we still like one more. They're the new types of enemies, these guys, the jumping guys. Let's kill this guy, then the bottom guy, then the top guy.
Complete.
Yeah, I lost some multiplayer also by dying. I have 5 bombs, that's nice. Gonna want use one in the last. I'm gonna lose all of my stuff in the last world for the boss. I'm not saying that the boss is hard because it's not by now, but it could trick out some people at first. About this level is that there are like lots of enemies, so here's a good way to get like points. Shit. Maybe I suck at this game. Well, we will come back to what we have used to. And I don't think we will be getting any special equipment, that's unfortunate.
Phase complete.
Nah. We can always try. Just be quick. Yeah, we didn't get the special human.
Multiplier up. Shields expired.
Shop. I'm sad now because of you. Well, that wasn't the best run. I love the way that every kill refreshes the boost a bit. And that's true. Well, we got all of the humans we could have. Okay, there's so many different game mode types.
Shields expired. Overdrive charged.
I will need overdrive really badly for the boss. And you guys will see why in a second. That was epic. And that gave me a good boost. A good point boost. Now it's always good to attack spots when he is facing you, and you know when he is facing you or not. His face side fireballs are not going as far as his backside fireballs. See, they're like spreading out more. Also, don't be afraid for enemies to hit your ship, because enemies can hit your ship, but they can't hit your middle of the ship, or else you'll die. Now what I'm gonna do is gonna ignore it, go for the boss.
Armageddon.
And that's the bomb. I just used the bomb. Make it look epic. Oh yeah, that's the photo mode. I think it's pretty neat. Okay. So if you want to make it, okay, I'm just gonna show it. If you want to make a cool screenshot, you can like go around here and there, look around also. I want to have a screenshot like that. Okay. Please give me out. Well, it was free, so please hit the like button who still has it. 36 million. I'm not gonna play any more of it because I want to show you guys some other game modes. Let's just exit the game. There are challenges. Apparently I can't go any further because my parents just, of course, have to call me when I'm doing a flipping video. Be right back.